In the ring right now, Constant and Ashley for a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Total weight, 606 pounds out of Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Iron Mike Sharpe, his partner from the Ozark Mountains, J.R. Hogg. And going against him from Louisville, Kentucky, at 457 pounds, Steve Constant. Tim Ashley, one-fall, 10. Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
Hello again, everybody. Lance Russell and Dave Brown right along ringside, ready to go with another big, exciting day of championship wrestling. And David, what a way to start out with a very red-hot Louisville combo of Constant and Ashley.
They have looked good in recent weeks, I've got to tell you, and they're in here today against some big, big competition, over 600 pounds for Iron Mike Sharpe. Don't forget about that right arm of Iron Mike Sharpe with that brace he's got on it. His partner, J.R. Hogg, out of the Ozark Mountains. Coming up later today, Jerry Oski will be here. Lanny Poffo, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, Fabulous Ones, much more. Championship Wrestling today. Iron Mike Sharpe. Stumbling back to the corner, made the tag. J.R. Hogg in there right now. Constant and Ashley make the tag. Tim Ashley takes over with a headlock. Constant had good results with this, so Tim kind of taking over where he left off. Down to the mat goes J.R. Hogg. Boy, that's good work by the team of Constant and Ashley. Try to sap the strength early of these big opponents. Because they have such size, you can't afford to make a mistake against them. J.R. Hogg. He comes in at about 331 by himself. He tried the forearm, but didn't work. Over to the corner, the tag made. Steve Constant coming back in. Constant and Ashley. We saw him here very early in their wrestling career, and that was not that long ago. And they have developed about as quickly as any tag team that we've ever seen here on Championship Wrestling. They have really looked good lately. Look out, Mike Sharpe grabbing him. Head into the top turnbuckle. Don't let this big guy take control, and that's what Sharpe is trying to do right now against Steve Constant. Grabs him by the arm, fires him into the turnbuckles. Constant out of the way. Alert move by Steve Constant avoided a possible disaster there as Mike Sharpe was coming after him with all 275 pounds. Constant again working that headlock. This time, Sharpe fires him into the ropes, a shoulder butt. Sharpe hits the mat, back up on his feet. This time, Constant leaps over. Good drop kick, puts Sharpe down to the mat. Tag made. Tim Ashley will be coming in. Dave Brown, Lance Russell here at ringside with Championship Wrestling for you. Big action coming up. Big action right now. Look out, Sharpe with a right fist to the midsection. There's a broad arm across the back of the neck. Hammers Tim Ashley down on one knee. Whip into the rope. Ashley ducks under. Presses him down to the mat. One, two. J.R. Hogg is there to break it up at the two count. It looked like Ashley might have him there for a moment. Ashley quickly back to work. Sharpe quickly reacts and puts him in a head scissors. There you see it, the head scissors put on by Mike Sharpe. Tag made, J.R. Hogg coming in now. He put a boot right underneath the rib cage of Tim Ashley down on the mat. Big J.R. Hogg picking up Tim Ashley. Oh, backs him into a corner. Oh, he's biting. Ashley, whoa, in the turnbuckles, and Hogg came flying in and just ran right into him. Just head-on collision here. Tries it again. This time Ashley moves out of the way. J.R. Hogg grabs him as Ashley was on his way to the corner to tag his partner. Steve Constant waiting over there.
See Hogg call for the knee. He got it.
He's got it. And there's Ashley's head run right into it. Here is Mike Sharpe coming back. Ashley, he's reaching. He's close to the tag. Not quite close enough. The boot, the tag, Steve Constant over the top rope, comes after Sharpe and J.R. Hogg, both of them in there. Steve Constant having to take on both of them here. Look out, Sharpe grabs him. J.R. Hogg and Tim Ashley going at each other across the way. It's Mike Sharpe and Steve Constant in the other corner. Reversal. Hogg and Mike Sharpe run together, drop kick, and boy, what power as Constance just shoved Sharpe. He went out of the ring. They both take on J.R. Hogg. He's down on the mat. There's a cover. Can he make it stick? Two, three, got it.
Steve.
5 minutes, 31 seconds of action. What teamwork from Constance and Ashley as they defeat the much larger team of Iron Mike Sharpe and J.R. Hogg.
I'm not going to put those drop kicks up in the Classic Hall of Fame for drop kicks, Dave, but they got the job done. They were two against one, yeah. Who's talking? You guys double team. Mike Sharpe up there screaming and hollering away. That one drop kick where he nailed Sharpe, a little bit tight, but boy, he had the full leg power. He kicked it all out.
He followed
that
through.
Big 200, and, yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Just like the golf swing, he went all the way through that son of a gun, and he got him right out here on the floor. Then they double-teamed. Bang! And again, they weren't quite. That was no Coco Ware type up in there, a thing of beauty, but did it get the job done?
Certainly.
You better
did.
Believe it. What was that time?
5:31.
5:31. Son of a gun, that's the way it is. We got a lot of action. Don't you dare go away. We're going to be back with it in just one moment.
You know who sells the best-selling car, not only in Memphis, but America? Who sells the car that's changed people's minds about buying imports? Your Memphis area Chevy dealer. The car, the front-wheel drive Chevy Cavalier. Now with an exciting new feature, 8.8 GMAC financing. Chevy Cavalier. The price, just $66.06. At your Memphis area Chevy dealer. Isn't it great to love a car you can afford?
Where I sit, the most important thing you can do for your car is to change its oil regularly. Right now, you'll save big on Napa's best 10W40 motor oil. And if you change your oil, you should change your oil filter, right? Your Napa man has Napa oil filters on sale for just $249. These are Napa's best filters, made to keep your engine running better.
Save big on Napa's best 10W40 motor oil for 69 cents a quart, and Napa oil filters just $249.
Make a change to the best. Make it Napa brand new.
It's true.
There is a difference. I proved it to myself.
At Walmart, we want you to compare. Our low prices really set us apart. Walmart doesn't discount just a few items. We discount every item in every department every day. True discount prices every day. That's savings at your convenience.
That's savings.
That's real savings. That's Walmart.
That's real savings. That's the Walmart way.
This is Furniture Center's biggest super sale ever, and I want to show you how we can save you hundreds of dollars on this lovely five-piece dining room suite. Featuring country charm styling plus quality craftsmanship and design, we dare you to compare this pattern and price at any other store. You'll find true savings at our super sale price of $4.99, a savings of $200 or more. Plus, you get free delivery, free setup, and six ways to pay at Furniture Center's super sale.
One fall, 10-minute time limit match from parts unknown at 227 pounds, the Invader. And going against him from Hartford, Connecticut at 230 pounds, Jerry Oski. This match, one fall, 10-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
Bell time, and we're off and running as Oski is out against the Invader in there. We've been calling him Oski, and I'm delighted finally that Jerry got us straight on that, because we hate, like the devil, to be called in by the wrong name. Jerry Oski. I don't care how you call it, brother. He is on a string coming into this area. He has really been going well. Nice move went around behind, had the hammer lock, and stepped away very quickly right off the ropes. Oski, a leg dive, single, picked him up, steps over, spins on it with a toe hold, and the Invader down on the deck. He loses it, goes into a side headlock, also on the canvas. Oski caught with a head scissors, but he's out of it in a hurry, and Jerry Calhoun steps in and says, "Watch the fist, please." Everything up to this point has been going well. What a dandy of a move. But the Invader, also making a good move, got to the ropes, took advantage, and the referee breaks it up. Jerry, not wasting any time, comes in behind, hooks the knee, takes him over, and with a 1-2 on it, goes to reverse face lock. He's got him chin locked from behind. Jerry Oski, Hartford, Connecticut. He is out in front, obviously, if we were scoring by points in the first 1:20, and there is Calhoun checks him to see they're on the ropes. That'll call for a break. And a break he gets, steps in between. That's dangerous territory, I can tell you. Have seen a referee nail from time to time. But that's what their job is. Side mare puts him on the deck. The Invader down, and Jerry Oski rolled back toward the rope, but he wasn't quite in him. A count of one as he was rolled up with both shoulders down. Oski has a combination of good speed and size. He is not a giant. By the same token, he has got the speed of a guy of 220 pounds. Jerry goes more than that. Well built, spent a lot of time. As a youngster, he had baseball stars in his eyes. Got involved with wrestling and son of a gun. That made his mind up in a hurry. Shoulder puts the Invader down, and once again, the mayor has him down on the mat in a side headlock. Hooks him down there. The referee to check, but obviously no close, not even close to a pin. We're in the second bout of the day in the opening match. Constant and Ashley with a good win over Sharpe and J.R. Hogg. Jerry Oski going in the Invader against a one fall, 10-minute time limit bout. Ooh, big elbow. Invader moving into the corner. Puts a knee, didn't catch him too solid, and Oski is able to fire out of there. Lines him up and shoots a right, and the referee says open him up. Going for a suplex as he takes him up in the air, drops him, snaps him over, rolls him down on the mat. Boy, that was a dandy. Used a little catapult off that top rope, David.
Yeah, a little extra spring that way.
Had the big guy up in the air, and he dropped his legs down, and that's what catapulted him off. Slingshot effect. Pressing him up over the head. Goes with a body slam. It's going to be a 1-2-3. We got a winner.
You can just feel that that one was over right there.
Yes.
Oski gets the win in 3:33.
3:33. That followed up after that very good move where he popped the catapult off the rope with the feet, slammed him over on that suplex. Here it is for a big slam. Oski hooks the leg, brings him into pin position. He's got it. 3:33. Jerry Oski, a winner. I tell you what, coming in right now, we're ready to go right ahead with it, is Lanny Poffo.
His opponent making his way up toward the ring right now. It's a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match for Memphis, Tennessee at 235 pounds. Introducing David Haskins, and going against him from St. John's, New Brunswick, Canada, 235 pounds, Lanny Poffo. This match, one fall, 10. Jerry Calhoun again will be your referee.
This will be an interesting combination. That's almost always the case in Poffo, and you saw a sample of it right there. When he comes out against an opponent, you know you're seeing one of the best gymnasts in the entire professional wrestling. He's going against a young fella who has learned his fundamentals well, David Haskins. I hope that this comes across right, but I got to be honest and say, David, I think, needs a little imagination in his wrestling. He's excellent on his fundamentals, but there are times when you just can't go by what the book says. Here's what you follow with. You got to use a little imagination.
I agree with you. You can't just go head on all the time. And that's
right.
One thing the gymnastics does for Poffo. In football, I think they call it misdirection. And that's kind of what Poffo is able to do. And it's worked very, very well for him. It's working right now. Lanny Poffo puts Haskins down on the mat. He goes after him. Now, that'll work for you, too, but that's illegal.
Yes.
He's using a right fist, pounding away at David Haskins. Haskins tried to get back on his feet. Boot to the top of the head. As long as you use the bottom of the boot, by the way, that's legal. I hadn't covered that rule in a long time. You hit him with the point of the toe, that's not legal, but flat of the boot, that's okay.
Something else we may have not have covered in a while, for those of you who may have been hidden away in a cave somewhere, Lanny Poffo is Randy Macho Man Savage's brother, and you can tell with these two guys, the blood is thick.
Whoa! A kick from the side, puts Haskins to the mat, he goes after him. He was choking him. We were blocked over here, couldn't see it well, but there was little doubt that he was choking because the referee was frantically counting for a break. Slam by Poffo. He just leaves Haskins lying in the ring. Now Lanny steps out on the apron. He uses his version of the catapult, and he's in there. He doesn't try to go for the three count, though.
Two series ago is what put Haskins in bad shape. Good suplex. Got him over and down. Haskins is very thick, heavy. Oh, look at that. Uh-huh.
That's it. Well, it was all Lanny Poffo. Once he took control, he kept it. He got the three count rather handily there. 2 minutes, 20 seconds, the time on it. Lanny Poffo, the winner over David Haskins.
It was, in fact, a good win, as Haskins is no easy touch, and the misdirection and all came through with Poffo. Jerry Oski. Jerry, we've been calling you by the wrong name, Oski. I wish you'd have said something sooner.
Well, me and Jerry did the Jerry Lawler show last week for today,
yeah.
And we corrected it on there, so it'll be a short time until everybody knows it anyway.
I got to say one thing. I don't care whether it's Oski, Oski, or what, you're still winning, partner, and I love it.
Well, thank you, Lance, and you know I love to be here. You know, I came out to say, we're down to business now. One thing and one thing only. I'm going to be the next Mid-South champion. I don't care how long it takes me to do it. This time is one thing I've got plenty of.
Well, you know, of course, that the Macho Man is the guy with a title right at the moment. And, of course, Lawler is looking for him. And he wants, and you, boy, hey, come on now, Lanny. Hey.
I don't mean to insult you. I'm not trying to insult you. But you're an incoherent, babbling fool. Okay, now let's keep it civil. Let's have a little...
Please, let's do that.
A little propriety. No man comes to the Macho Man except by me. All right? Now, you've got some good credentials. Your biceps are a little larger than your brain. Now, if you're a man enough, I'm going right into the ring. You follow me in.
No.
Well, you just lead the way, buddy. Let's go right now.
No, Jerry, we're not going to have it. Let's take a break right now. I don't want it. No. We're going to take a break. We're not going to get into any of that brawling stuff.
Don't take it out on your battery. Tune up for fast starts at Expert Tune. Your engine is computer-analyzed and expertly tuned by certified mechanics you can talk to. A 30-minute guaranteed tune-up at Expert Tune costs less than a new battery. Expert Tune. For starters. Discover the quick response and smooth performance of Exxon Extra, our highest octane unleaded premium gasoline ever. Its extra boost of octane quiets the knocks, silences the pings for extra smooth performance. Exxon Extra. Quality you can count on.
Double cheese, burger, please.
Seems like the times keep changing, but now an old-time favorite is back. double cheeseburgers back for McDonald's 30th birthday for a limited time.
It's always a good time for the great taste.
Double double cheeseburger, please.
A McDonald's.
To celebrate our 30th birthday, McDonald's has a double good deal on our delicious double cheeseburger. Just 99 cents at McDonald's.
I don't want to be negative, but I got to say this. The crowd has their own opinion of Tux Newman, and here he is, entrepreneur, outstanding manager from the West Coast, Tux Newman.
You do show intelligence. You know, Lance Russell, a great orator once said, even a wrestler who is pure at heart and says his prayers by night can become a wild moondog when the moon is full and bright. You know who that orator was?
No, who was that, Tux?
Me! That's who it was. And with me right now is Moondog Rex. And you know that it took me a long time to acquire his services because you can't really even talk to him. You've got to kind of growl and grunt. That's what he understands, you see.
Yeah, I know,
and he smiles a lot. But you know why he is smiling? Because he knows that Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum, do you know who I've got my Moondog against?
I know, but
you
let's tell them.
Let's tell them. Tommy Rich! Tommy Rich! Can you believe that?
Wildfire will be back.
They call him Wildfire.
Right.
Now, you see, we're going to put out his fire. Here is a young boy who held the NWA Heavyweight Championship. I give him that credit.
Right.
But what has he done since? Nothing! Now, you know what I have? I have a wild maniac who also was a champion, if these fans will remember, with his partner. They tore up the Mid-South Coliseum. Now, I have brought back the strongest of the two, and I'm talking about Rex right here. What do you think that a puny little blonde wildfire Tommy Rich is going to do against this man?
Well, you apparently have forgotten a lot of other things about Rich, because Rich, when the necessity comes about, can get down with it, forget the rules like nobody you've ever seen. He's not going to be the only one who
there's,
can fight.
There's no such thing as rules in this match coming up Monday night. You know why? Because the Moondog's here, and the Moondog's going to eat him up, going to growl and going to snort. I'm going to chew him. And Tommy Rich, if you're watching, I suggest you bring everything you got to the Coliseum this Monday. Say goodbye to all your fans, because you're never coming back, Tommy Rich.
Okay, that's
never.
Fine, Tux. We'll see him in the ring right
Tommy
now.
Rich,
David,
we
got the match. Yeah, I know. We got the match coming up. Let's see the Moondog in the ring, Dave.
Got a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Moondog jumps in there. He's the international roughneck at 264 pounds. His opponent from Hamden, Connecticut, at 230 pounds, Billy Travis. One-fall, 10-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
I like young Billy Travis. Got a lot of class to him. He's a youngster, not as big as some of the wrestlers, but that's not to say he is a lightweight by any means. If the Moondog will get rid of that bone, the referee calls for the bell, but Moondog Rex has still got that bone in his hand. I don't think I have to remind any of the championship wrestling fans about the Moondog. Tux Newman is a new face at ringside with a Moondog in the ring. Billy Travis straight ahead with him, ties it, and he's given up a lot of weight. And you see the result of it. He's rushed to the ropes and takes a right, another one. And the Moondog starts right away slashing at him. Misses with a nearly run a clothesline. That shows you the Moondog has been around the block a couple of times himself, Dave.
Yes.
Shin locks him from behind and really putting the pressure on.
Let's pretend that that's Tommy Rick. Okay? Okay.
Well, let me tell you, with all due respect to Billy Travis, he has not been against the class competition that Rich has, and no way can you put Wildfire in the shoes of Billy Travis at the moment. Newman trying to agitate him down there, saying, it's Tommy Rich, go get him. And the Moondog again. Back to that chin lock. He's got his hands hooked and really putting some pressure on him. Travis slams into him, but can't get him off his feet. Lion press, and he does. One. Oh, good. Nice. Woo. Moondog fired him right through the ropes and out on the floor. He is down in the proximity of Newman. Moondog slams the head down on the ring apron.
Well, it all started when Billy Travis missed that drop kick. Moondog has been unrelenting since then.
Boy, he drilled him with that knee, too. Slipping back down to the studio floor as the referee runs the Moondog away. Newman is up. We're keeping an eye on him. He is, there he is. He is just to the left of Travis. I'm watching that cane, but he is on his good behavior right at the moment as he does not, in fact, cheap shots at Billy Travis. He's leaving that up to the Moondog. Travis back in the ring, and the Moondog rips him with a right and catches him with another one. Yeah, you called it, Dave. It was that miss on that drop kick that has really put Billy in very bad shape. The Moondog slams his head into the top turnbuckle. That, of course, is Tux Newman. You're looking over his shoulder as the Moondog picks him up. Back slam. Trots down over the top of him. 2-3. And the Moondog Rex comes out victorious over Billy Travis. And the youngster from Hammond, Connecticut, made a mistake that you can't afford to do against a vet like the Moondog. And the referee, you better do something about control him. He'll disqualify him, too.
Anybody goes again. Anybody.
Yeah. He comes off the ropes and double hands Billy Travis down. The winner, the Moondog. Time was what?
3:29.
3:29. And Travis ends up missing the drop kick and losing the match in 3:29 to Moondog Rex. But I still repeat, by no way can you make a comparison between Billy, with all respect to the youngster from Connecticut, and Tommy Wildfire Rich. Here's a little salute to the man we call Wildfire.
Road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. Road again, like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way, and our way on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again.
Rich, and you'll see Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum.
Within the mix, there's no thirst that Sprite can't get.
It's all in one mix.
Only Sprite has lime.
What a mix!
It's all in one mix.
taste of lime. Ooh, the taste of lemon too. It tastes of limony, and still it's caffeine free. Cause it's only Sprite for you. What a mix!
Right now at Kmart, our Glidden Spread Satin is on sale for just $7.99 a gallon.
The important thing is, you could win one of 10 Jeep CJs.
Glidden Spread Latex Enamel is only $10.97.
Of course, there's no purchase necessary to win the Jeep.
At these prices, we're practically giving away Glidden.
We are giving away Jeeps.
Good point.
You can't do better than Kmart.
When you play the Domino's Pizza No Problem game, you can win some pretty nice prizes.
Hey, I want a free bottle of Coke.
Just rub off the question bar on your game card and match it up with the correct answer.
Hey, I want a free pizza.
There are over 8 million prizes, including...
Hey, Roddy just won a Porsche!
5 Porsche 944 sports cars. Play the Coke Domino's Pizza No Problem game. 3 out of every 4 game cards an instant winner. Domino's Pizza delivers.
How to ride a Honda scooter.
First, select shirt-pant combo.
We suggest this.
Or this.
Next, select appropriate shoes. We suggest two.
Then choose a scooter that best expresses your individuality. There are many sizes and colors.
And always wear your helmet.
Honda scooters. They're everything but ordinary.
Boy, it's been a while. The universal heartthrob, Austin Idol, coming to town. Universal heartthrob, Austin Idol. Son of a gun, hadn't been with us for a long time, and I'll tell you what, I am really looking forward to the fact that he will be back at the Mid-South Coliseum on Monday night. I guess maybe they can kind of get an idea of the excitement that's going to be taking place down there on Monday night when we have already told you that Rich is going to be there and the heartthrob. Let's hear some words about the upcoming match from Austin.
One of the biggest nights in the history of pro wrestling coming to Memphis, the Mid-South Coliseum Monday night, and one of the reasons, one of the greatest box office attractions at pro wrestling, the universal heartthrob Austin Idol comes back to Memphis, Tennessee.
And I can't wait for it. You know something, Charlie? Promoter Eddie Marlin called Austin Idol long distance in Las Vegas, Nevada, and he said, break all your commitments. He says, put everything on hold, because I'll pay you 10 times the amount of money that any other wrestling promoter will pay you for one single night in wrestling in the Mid-South Coliseum right here in Memphis, Tennessee. What do you think I said, Charlie? I said, bring on the Learjet so we know Austin Idol's going to show up. We won't have to worry about no misconnections in the Atlanta airport. We know the Idol says he's coming. I'm coming to town. And you know something? I don't care who I'm wrestling. And I know the folks in Memphis, they don't care who I'm wrestling either. They say, is Austin Idol still rich? Oh, of course he is. Is he still mean? The baddest you ever seen. Is he still sexy? Oh, move over, Tom Selleck. Sit down, Burt Reynolds. And step aside, Sylvester Stallone. Because the one and only 242 pounds, Las Vegas, Nevada, the women's pet, the men's regret, is coming home.
In the ring right now for a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match from Memphis, Tennessee at 214 pounds, Jim Jameson. And going against him from Las Vegas, Nevada at 250 pounds, the international playboy, Bobby Colt. This match will be one-fall, 10-minute time limit match. Referees Jerry Calhoun.
Right away, Colt across the ring. Plenty of size on his side. As he jumps Jameson right just before the bell. He had started before the referee had signaled for the bell. Slams him across with a backbreaker. One, two, three. Ooh. Tell me, how quick can you get?
Boy, I tell you what, Bobby Colt took advantage of his size and experience against Jim Jameson, and he beat him in 18 seconds. 18 seconds, the time of the match.
There it is, a win as
Duma. I don't know about Nick Bockwinkel, Lance Russell. Does he know about Nick Bockwinkel? What happened to him, man?
You know he knows all about it.
Yeah.
You know, I am so excited about what has happened last week at the Mid-South Coliseum. It does my heart good just to see a man like this finally get what he deserves. It only took 7 weeks. Do you know that we defeated the AWA World Heavyweight Champion? Was Jerry Lawler ever able to defeat the AWA Champion? No, that's the answer. And I want all the fans to see the night that all this historic event happened. Can we show?
Yeah, oh, this is Tux Newman's tape, by the way.
Why don't we show this? But look at this. Look, isn't this gorgeous? Isn't this beautiful? For once, Lance Russell, you show an honest tape of what happened. Now look at this. There he is, flat on his back.
Fox,
he's the winner.
Russell.
Tell Jerry Lawler that, man. Make sure he knows. Time to back out. Yeah, time to back out.
Okay, you move him out
of
here.
It's true, because Lawler's been saying, if I don't beat Bockwinkel, I'll retire, and all this garbage. It only took us one match, and we pinned the AWA World Champion to the mat. And I'm telling you that you are looking at the uncrowned World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion.
Well, you see, in the ring right now, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. And just like the tape, it was not the entire match, so you didn't get to see what precipitated the 1-2-3. He did get a victory over Bockwinkel. We're ready for it. Let's go to Dave in the introduction.
One fall, 10-minute time limit match. Randy Savage jumped Mark Batten as he hits for the ring. The referee says, ring the bell, we're underway. Savage has got his warm-up robe off. Batten still has his warm-up vest on. Macho Man Randy Savage up on the rope, springs off the middle rope, and Mark Batten, the victim, as he nailed him with the upper arm. Batten hung upside down in the rope by Randy Savage. Savage just leaves him hanging there as he kicks him in the chest. Looked like he's standing on his chin now.
Come on, ref. Give him a break. Get him broken.
Here comes Mark's brother, Brad Batten, from behind. Grab Savage. He was watching this in the dressing room and decided to do something about it. Savage jumps him over the top rope down onto the floor. Savage off the ropes, and Brad Batten hits the floor. Mark Batten, meanwhile, still lying in the ring. Tux Newman calling Savage back. Mark Batten is the official Batten brother in this match. Savage grabs him. Clothesline puts him down to the mat. Savage heads for the turnbuckles again. Yeah, a little right-on handshake for Tux Newman. Savage standing on the middle rope.
Man, he is getting more vicious every week, Dave.
There's the count of three, and that's it. Randy Savage, the Macho Man, with a one-sided win over Mark Batten, and Brad Batten, too, was thrown out down on the floor. There's Mark.
There's no excuse in that.
No.
No excuse in that.
Minute 35.
No excuse? You're no excuse. That's what you're no on. Yes, this is a champion right here. And you know, speaking of champions, it's lonely at the top. And I want all the fans to see a real man right now. What do you think of that?
Well, I know what you've got. Another tape, and I'm sure it involves the Macho Man. Okay, Randy. Yeah. Let's take a look at it.
Offer the lowest prices if you don't have to prove it. Central prices are the lowest. Nobody but nobody can beat our rate. We're selling a new Whirlpool appliance, RCA TVs, VCRs at rates you won't believe. The best rental deals in town on RCA and Whirlpool. Shop around, get a price, then come and make me beat it. Over 20,000 satisfied Memphians have found the best deal at Central. I personally guarantee it.
Kentucky Fried Chicken. Our Kentucky nuggets taste so good. Do you dip them in sauce or not?
To dip or not to dip?
I think I'll go for a dip. But then again...
Dip. No. Nuggets.
Only our nuggets are made with the Colonel's secret blend of 11 herbs and spices. So they don't need sauce, but we've got it. So...
You can dip it or you can skip it.
Nuggets. We do chicken fried.
For a limited time, Mid-South, your GMC truck team brings you the Great American Truck in red, white, and blue. Special striping and logo, and its own Great American Options package at a Great American price. So come on and show your true colors in a full-size GMC pickup or a GMC Jimmy. It's the Great American Truck, only at Foster, Mary, Pryor, Hudson Rook, and General Truck. Your GMC truck team's son.
I hate California. You know what I'm saying? It's like, have a nice day, surf's up. I mean, their idea of culture is yogurt. formal dinner party means you wear socks. Blondes everywhere, pink tofu, excuse me, soy burgers. I really hate it. I even hate what they drink.
What do you have, buddy?
One of those.
California Cooler. One more reason to hate California.
We'll be getting to the entire card a little bit later on, but I'll tell you one thing that I am really looking forward to, and that is the return of the King, Lawler, who's been out of here for 3 weeks thanks to some brutality of Randy Macho Man Savage, will be returning. Let's take a listen right now to Jerry the King Lawler.
Well, I'm sure Randy Savage knows by now that the waiting is over. Let me tell you something, Savage. I want you to take a good look at this, brother, because I've looked at it now for about 3 weeks. I've watched it over and over, time and time again. And you know, at first I sat there and I looked at this kind of film and I thought, what could possess a guy? What goes through a guy's brain to try to pull a stunt like this? And finally, I quit trying to wonder. I quit trying to figure you out, Savage. Because it's enough to know that you don't think. It's enough to know that you're a brainless piece of slime who goes in the ring, and just because a jerk like Tux Newman tells you to finish somebody and end their career, that's good enough for you. That's what you try to do. Well, let me tell you something, Savage. I'm back, brother. I'm back, and I'm well, and my neck is ready to go, and I'm sitting on dead ready for you, punk. And oh, sure, you put me out. You laid me up. And during that time, I had a lot of time to think. Some of the thoughts that went through my mind weren't too pleasant. I had a lot of people tell me, you know, King, you've had a long career. You've had a good career. Maybe this is a good opportunity to hang up the boots, put the tights away, call it quits. And I contemplated that for a while, Savage, till I kept watching this film, till I kept watching those pile drivers. And then I knew, brother, it's no way. It's no way that this is going to be my last appearance in a wrestling ring. It's no way that the last time the wrestling fans are going to see the King, that I'm going to be carried out of the ring on a stretcher, and that I'm going to be put in the back of an ambulance, and I'm going to be hauled off to an ambulance. It's no way. I'm not quitting that way, I can assure you, Randy Savage. I got a lot of fight left in me, brother, and you're going to find out just how much Monday night. Monday night. It's been a long time since I could say that I'm going to be at the Coliseum, that I'm going to be in the ring Monday night, but I'm saying it now. And I know what you're thinking, Savage. You're thinking, I better get Tux Newman. I better get Lanny Poffo. I better get the PYT Express. I better have them standing on dead ready to hit that ring when Lawler takes out his vengeance on me. Well, let me tell you something, punk. I've asked some friends to be there myself. Tommy Rich, the Fabulous Ones, Austin Idol. They're going to all be there, brother, and they're going to be watching my back. So you have anybody you want. You have them set to run in that ring, because my men are going to be ready too. What it's going to boil down to, Randy Savage, it's going to boil down to me and you, brother. It's going to boil down to the Macho Man and the King. And I can promise you, I've been laid up for the last time. It's your turn now, Savage. And Monday night, I'm coming for two things. I'm coming for my title, and I'm coming to show you, Savage, that the King is not dead. There's a lot left in the King, brother, and you're going to find out just how much. Because if anybody sees an ambulance, if anybody sees the inside of an emergency room, it's going to be you, Randy Savage, come Monday night.
By golly, I'll tell you one thing. When Jerry the King Lawler has a special, it is in fact special. Because here is a man that is an exception. He has done it all, except win the World Heavyweight Championship. The King right now has on his mind the Macho Man who put him out of action for 3 weeks. Let's take a look now at the very special Jerry Lawler.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung. May you grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong, and may you stay.
King Lawler, and I think the folks here really appreciate it. Here's a guy who's been so dedicated to professional wrestling, Davey, and I mean he has been out for some time now. He's back, and he is ready, and he's got one thing on his mind at this moment. It's not necessarily belts or anything else. It is the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Let's take a look at what Savage looks like. My boy, let's hear it all about Monday night down at the Mid-South Coliseum.
All right, the action starts right on time at the Mid-South Coliseum. Take a look at the card that we got for you. Regular prices are in effect. 8 o'clock is wrestling time. Children under 10, $1. The general admission. Tickets are available at the Coliseum and, of course, at all Ticketmaster locations. Opening match of the night, Speedy Tall Tree will be going against Mark Batten. Mark's brother, Brad, will be in there then, going against the big guy, Iron Mike Sharpe, in the next match of the evening. Then comes a tag team match. Nick Patrick, David Haskins teaming up to go against Randy Rose and Randy Rose's partner, Chick Donovan. That's the first tag team match of the night. There'll be more later on. Then it'll be Mr. Wrestling and Mr. X going against Ted and Jerry Oates in still another tag team match. In more wrestling action, we will have Steve Constant and Tim Ashley. Boy, they look good here today. They'll be going against Doug Summers and Jerry Bryant. Then it'll be Jerry Oski against Lanny Poffo in a single match. Following that, Bobby Colt steps into the ring against Austin Idol. Then it'll be Tommy Wildfire Rich against the Moondog. That's not all. Return AWA Southern Tag Team title match coming up. The PYT Express and the Fabulous Ones, both tag teams in the ring. One of them trying to take away the Southern Tag Team titles. Then, in that grudge match that we've been talking about, in this one, the King, Jerry Lawler, going against the Macho Man, Randy Savage. It's all Monday night. Regular prices will be in effect. at the Mid-South Coliseum.
You got to repeat that, David. Regular prices?
Regular prices are in effect. Children under 10 admitted general admission for $1.
10?
Hey, don't tell me that right there.
Come on, hey. Come on, Savage. Come on, Newman, get this guy out of here. Hey, listen, come on.
Come on,
Ray. Get this crazy guy out of here now. Come on, Tux. What? You got that right.
Get out of the way. Don't touch me. Don't touch me right now. You're ready to stand back. Get that thing in on me right now. Hey, Lawler, you stay away from me right now. I'll make sure nobody wrestles again. Forever young. Jerry Lawler, I want you to understand one thing right now. Stay away from me right now. You're talking forever young, baby. You're talking forever young. Monday night in the Mid-South Coliseum, you come on down and you bring your forever young, and I promise you one thing. I promise you that you won't walk out of there alive. You understand that? You understand that, Jerry? I'll bust you too. Get Lawler!
Marvell Austin, Coco Ware, and Tux Newman.
Now, first of all, you should say congratulations. That's the first word you should say. Why do we say congratulations? Because you fans are looking at the new Mid-South American Tag Team Champions, Southern Tag Team Champions. You know what that means to me? After only 7 weeks, and after only a few weeks of managing these men, they have done the impossible. They have beaten the fabulous ones, and they are the champions. Tell us.
They did, in fact.
Well, Lance, why don't you congratulate us, you know, because we are the champions. We ain't found a team yet that can beat us. And we told Steve and Stan that we would drop them just like with yesterday's garbage, and we did so. So, baby, they want a rematch. So anywhere, any place, and any time, we'll be ready for you guys, baby, because we're fired up. We're fired up, baby. And Steve and Stan, get ready, because we will be the champion from now on out, baby, because there's no team alive can beat the Pretty Young Thing Express.
Let's show the people the night it happened. Fair and square.
For those who were not here, here it is. PYP and the Fabulous One.
Stan Lane's trying to come in to save it. He got the title.
Count of 1, 2, 3.
That's it. We won!
How do
we won! We are the champions!
If we do what we said, we're going to do
it. We won the Southern Tag Belt. There's no question about that.
Well, why are you so disgusted about that? You should be happy. You should be happy. We did it fair. We did it square. We did it right down the middle of the ring. We pinned them, and that's all there is to it. They're history. Stan and Steve, you are history. Pack your bag. Leave this
you
house.
Know
go anywhere.
Behind Jackie Fargo. That's where they're at now. You want to take on Hulk Hogan's land, Russell?
We gave you your moment.
That's
hop
right.
to the ring. You
we
got a match coming
we're champions,
up.
Baby.
We are
here.
We are the champions.
That's right, but we can back it up.
Okay, David.
What else we can say? What else we can
we're ready for the action in the ring. PYT going to the ring now to go against Tracy Smothers and Keith Berry.
Yeah, okay. We hear you. This is a non-title match up there, and introducing at a total weight 431 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, Keith Eric, his partner from Springfield, Tennessee, Tracy Smothers, going against him at a total weight of 447 pounds. with the AWA Southern Tag Team Championship. Norvell, Austin, Coco Ware, PYT, the Pretty Young Things, they're from Memphis and Union City, Tennessee. Tux Newman in their corner. This match is one fall, 10-minute time limit, and Jerry Calhoun, the referee. We're waiting for his signal right now.
Gotta tell you, the past history, recent history of Austin and Ware, there's not much competition in store for them here. Tracy Smothers, Keith Eric, a couple of good young fellas, but brother, I'm telling you what, this PYT been on a tear, all four of them in the ring. As a backdrop, put Smothers down in the center of the ring. There's a tag on Norvell Austin. Referee Jerry Calhoun watching them as they... So many moves that are not just tough, they are vicious. Backbreaker, Norvell follows with a big elbow, and they have been murdered. High-flying knee, and Coco puts Smothers into it. Holy mackerel, he got up and kicked the lights out of Tracy Smothers. Smothers, a big kid, about 6'3½" or so, and Coco was up even with him. Norvell just absolutely destroyed him with that elbow. I don't need any comments out of Tux Newman about it. I can see everything that's happened. Right in behind with that knee to the midsection. Smothers whipped across the ring. Backdrop, Coco, Norvell. They're even looking more vicious since they got the titles, Dave.
They are. Just nonstop action from Norvell and Coco.
Both knees right in the midsection. Gasping for breath, Tracy Smothers. No rest, though, as Norvell takes over. The referee trying to get Coco Ware back out of the way. Woo! He got him with a forearm. It was on the rope, but it wasn't a fist. It was a forearm. And you could see his head just snap. Power slam. Waist locked him. Drove him into the canvas. Big elbow. And poor Tracy is absolutely destroyed in there. Reverse neck breaker. Dropped. I know they're the champions. Non-title bout. And they are just pouring it on like there is no excuse for it. Norvell and Coco, as devastating as any team that we have seen recently. They just continue to pour it on Tracy's mother. Eric has not even been in the ring as yet. Norvell, Coco going at it. Coco Ware drops him straight down. Across the neck with that lower leg. Hang on, Norvell Austin. However many minutes this has been, it has been nothing but slaughter. Tracy Smothers being pounded and pounded.
It's been about 3 minutes, and there has not been any way that Smothers could even catch his breath.
And he isn't catching his breath, as he again is just gasping for air as Coco takes over. This looks to me like it might be a good discretionary call by the referee, as there's a tag going to Norvell Austin, and they just continue to slam and slam away on Tracy Smothers. Yeah, I can tell you're really torn up, Tex. Smothers fires a right, but it was weak and feeble and no effect whatsoever. Southern Tag Champs obviously dominating this match. It is so one-sided. What a crime. Letting a young fellow like Smothers just absolutely get pounded. And he won't quit. He keeps firing.
We're coming up to 4 minutes. I seriously doubt. Oh, Smothers trying to find his corner. He got the tag.
Hey, goes Keith Eric. He's new, but he's at least fresh in the ring and fires Norvell in. Norvell pushes off a drop kick, drops Keith Eric down, and whips him across the ring. There's that high-flying knee that's a trademark of Norvell Austin. Tag on Coco Ware and a PYT. With a big body slam, Coco takes over from here. He may be lining him up for that brainbuster. Let's see. Takes him straight up in the air. He's got him like a suplex and drives him down into the mat, and that's going to be it. It's all over with. He'll hot dog it a little before he lets Norvell get the 1-2-3 on him. And Keith Eric driven hard into the mat. Kind of 1-2-3, and that's it. Winner is Norvell Austin Coco Ware. In a real slaughter, defeating Tracy Smothers and Keith Eric. Yeah, I know they won.
5 minutes even, the time on it, and you're right. Boy, Smothers and Eric never had a chance from the opening bell.
5 minutes, the winner is the champion, Southern Tank holder, Ware and Austin. Back in a moment.
Harry Sherman for BC Powder.
Forecast says rain.
When you're working the dirt,
gotta get this field plowed before the ground turns to mud.
And you're feeling the hurt.
No time for a headache. That's why I always keep a BC powder in my pocket.
That's the time to take BC.
I've tried other headache powders, but nothing gets me back to work faster than BC.
When the pain keeps growing, but you gotta keep going.
I gotta keep going.
That's the time to take BC.
When you gotta keep going.
Over 200,000 people just like you have taken advantage of Champion TV's Easy Rent-to-Own plan. Maybe because Champion gave away over $50,000 cash last year, plus thousands of dollars in merchandise. Maybe it's because Champion treats our customers right. Maybe it's because Champion has top quality products that you can rent-to-own hassle-free. This year we'll be giving away even more money. Call Champion now and find out how you can be a part of winning the Champion way.
Champion makes it easy to own.
Please, I'm on my way to Grandma's. Hey, how about some low-fat cottage cheese?
Maybe a Diet Cola?
Well, I was saving this for myself, but...
Hold out, hold out, for the out of the ordinary, sugar-free Dr. Pepper.
Mama warned me about wolves.
Hold out.
Christmas at this time of year, why not? Don't laugh. It could happen to you at Memphis AMC Jeep Renault, your credit connection. If you've had trouble financing a new car, listen, bad credit, slow credit, no credit, the credit connection can help. Come to Memphis AMC Jeep Renault. Pick out the car you really want. The credit connection could help you. Remember, there's only one credit connection, and it's right here at Memphis AMC Jeep Renault, 3254 Elvis Presley. Give them a call. They can help. That Christmas number is 345-1115.
Here they come, the fabulous ones, Stan Lane and Steve Kern. Well, we just witnessed a devastating bit of power by the PYT as they destroyed the two young guys who were in there with Steve.
You know, all I want to say, Lance, is, you know, it's hard to come out here and talk after losing the Southern Tag Team titles. But you didn't see much of the match on that film that I just watched. You didn't see the end results. All you saw was just a little piece of it. And I can't come out here and I can't talk big about what happened because, first of all, people don't ask how you lost. They don't ask where you lost. They just ask about you losing. Well, we've obviously lost because we don't have the titles. Now, our history speaks for itself, obviously, by what Jackie Fargo has done. And we owe that man our total wrestling career. And when you have to go back to Jackie Fargo and you have to explain to him, well, the belts are gone. You know, what can I say, Jackie? What can I get down and tell you about how we lost them? Except for that they're gone, and they're not coming back just by any reversal of a decision by a referee. Jackie says, tell me something, son. Is this the first time you've lost? I said, no. Will you ever lose again? I said, it's possible. I said, then get your chin up off that ground, boy, because let's start talking about teams. What happened to the Moondogs when they came in? They beat you. You came back. You're the only team in professional wrestling right now that holds a win over the Road Warriors. You've also beaten Jack and Jerry Briscoe, who are brothers, who one time held the NWA World Wrestling belt by himself, Jack Briscoe, three times. You've beaten team after team after team. Why is it that when you lose one, you come to me with your chin down and you're dragging? Get up, go back after it, and take them apart. And I'll tell you something, PYT, I don't care if you got Tux Newman. I don't care if you bring the Moondogs. I don't care if you bring Randy Macho Man Savage, Leapin' Lanny Poffo. You bring them all, because if they're all going to fall. Because if there's one thing the Fabs can do, and that's that they can come back, and they can bring it back together, and they can do just exactly what they do best, and that's beating other tag teams. PYT, you're at the top of the list, and you're going to go down. The Fabulous Ones are coming, and you know what's going to happen? And I'll put this in words that you'll understand. By the time you get done wrestling the Fabulous Ones, you're going to be saying, I pledge allegiance to the Fabs. Oreo, Oreo. You got it? Come on, stand.
Yeah, you know, we could stay out here with our heads down and stuff. We could stay out here with our chin on the floor, but are we going to do that? No, we're not. We're going to get up, guys. We're going to get sky high, baby, because we're not going to let two guys that drive a 63 Chevy with blue smoke blowing out the back and them wine bottles full out the window and them stealing stereos in the parking lot. We're not going to let you guys beat the Fabs. Get away with it, brother. We're going to have us a little party right now. We're no more crying, no more jiving. We're going to party. Turn my music on right now. Steal a stereo with a party. We're going to have a little Fab party right now, baby. Woo! Yeah, right. Woo! Woo!
Thank the PYT. Won't have something in store when they run into these guys the very next time. And it's Steve hitting to the ring, Dave.
And it's Steve, the Fabulous Ones, had a interaction here today.
What an explosion when they meet with a PYT again. Oh, you betcha. All right. Dan's got his party.
They are ready. Their opponents are standing up here waiting. They got a couple of assistants over here. Party time, they say. Heads got down. They're ready to wrestle. Here we go with this one fall 10-minute time limit match at a total weight of 455 pounds. From Memphis, Tennessee, Bill Rose and his partner from parts unknown, Mr. Wrestling, going against him at 459 pounds, both out of Florida, Stanley, Steve Kern, the Fabulous One. One fall, 10-minute time limit match, Jerry Calhoun, the referee.
Warrior Stevens starting out, going against Mr. Wrestling. Stan having a little trouble getting out of his chaps over there, and Steve fortunately doesn't need a tag on his partner at the moment. If he's got any plans in mind to keep the party going, you can better believe he's not going to be tagging out by necessity in there. They really are geared and wired higher than a kite, and this is for a team that lost the Southern tag belt. They are ready. Steve Kern dropping hard on Mr. Wrestling.
Big body slam by Steve Kern. Mr. Wrestling falls back to the corner. I don't think he made a tag. Nope, he's staying in there. Mr. Wrestling against Steve Kern.
Mr. Wrestling with a lot more experience. Bill Rose, the bigger of the two. Kern cranking the arm up. Makes a tag on Stan Lane. Stan through the ropes. Coming at him. Upper elbow. Into the corner. And Bill Rose takes over. There's that back kick from Lane. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Puts a little side kick up on him. Comes around. Good body slam. Bill Rose whipped into the ropes, and there's an elbow that he'll remember tomorrow. You can bet. Hey, can you tell that Stan and Steve are ready?
It is party time for him, I tell you. Ooh, look out.
Steve drove him into the top rope. Rested his chin on and popped him off of there. And we have a winner.
Took him about a minute and a half to do it as the Fabulous Ones came on strong and took the victory home.
Dan and Steve really cooperating very, very well. Never gave Rose and Mr. Wrestling an opportunity. Rose fired in. Look at Steve. Drives him over to the top rope. As the catapult rolls off and the cover, 1, 2, 3, the winners, the Fabulous Ones. Back in a moment.
If you're looking for quality auto parts, there's one place that should pop into mind. Auto Shack. Because Auto Shack carries a full line of the best parts in auto parts. Bendix for brakes, TRW for chassis and engine parts, plus other top-of-the-line brands like AC Delco, Motorcraft. You name it, Auto Shack has it. At savings up to 50%. And that could be the best part of all. Auto Shack. For people who don't have time to waste money.
The three quarters at Burger King.
We got three double cheeseburgers for the pound. Three double cheeseburgers, new taste in town. We got tacos without the jalapeno cheese. Pizza without the mozzarella cheese. We got mushroom double twist, a taste you don't want to miss. These double boneless, you better get the Burger King back.
Quarter pound double cheeseburgers are appearing for limited engagement.
Aren't you hungry for Burger King?
From the ceiling to the floor, from wall to wall, for any kind of fix it up, big or small, you always find more and you always pay less at Home Crafters Warehouse. Fix it up, you can do it, you'll see there's nothing to it. We can help you do it right and guarantee the lowest price. Anything that can be found, rooftop or to the ground, inside, outside, and all around. Home Crafters Warehouse, you always find more and always pay less.
Guaranteed.
Within 24 hours, the furniture that's on this truck can be in your home. 24 hours. That's all it takes to have a new living room, dinette, or bedroom in the latest styles from top manufacturers. Because now Remco has furniture that you rent to own. Just call us. You don't need credit, and you don't have to put up with factory delays. It's brand new furniture that you can rent for only a month, or own in only a year. It can be in your home in 24 hours if you call Remco right now.
When it comes to action, we love bringing it to you here on Championship Wrestling, but there's nothing like being right there at ringside. You can do that tonight in Palestine, Arkansas. Championship Wrestling will be there at the high school. 7:30 is wrestling time. Constant and Ashley will be there. PYT, the Batten Twins, all of them in Palestine tonight. Tomorrow, Cape Girardeau, Missouri for Championship Wrestling action. 7 o'clock tomorrow night in Cape Girardeau. The Fabulous Ones are headlining a super all-star card in Cape Girardeau, Missouri. Saturday night, next Saturday night, the 27th, Jonesboro, Arkansas. Tickets are available, and the box office will be open next Saturday at 3 o'clock, so you can buy your tickets in advance. That's in Jonesboro, 1 week from tonight. Then, coming up on Friday night, May 3rd, Blytheville, Arkansas, at the American Legion Arena. The King will be there, Constant and Ashley, all of them in Blytheville, Arkansas, Friday, May 3rd. Same night, Greenfield, Tennessee at the high school. Saturday, May 4th in Hohenwald, Tennessee for Championship Wrestling. Sunday night, the 5th, Jackson, Tennessee. Friday night, the 10th, Brownsville, Tennessee. Saturday, the 11th in Batesville, Mississippi. Tuesday, the 14th, Monette, Arkansas. And on Friday, May 24th, Championship Wrestling in Waverly, Tennessee. Don't forget, tonight, Palestine, Arkansas, big action over there.
When was the last time you took the family out to wrestling action? Let me tell you, friend, it is hotter right now than it ever has been. Make it a point. This coming week, catch one of those dates. We're going to be back with a final word from Championship Wrestling in just a moment.
LTD full-size sales event.
Featuring full-size savings on full-size luxury Fords.
Like this V8-powered Crown Victoria that comes with six-passenger comfort. And now you can save over $900 with a special option package that includes air conditioning plus 20 other options.
Or save over $1,100 on a similar luxury option package on this full-size LTD Brougham. These factory savings are in addition to your Ford dealer's own full-size discounts.
So check out his LTD full-size sales event today.
Thanks to Aaron Rent's low weekly rates on home electronics, people from all over have lots of savings to beam about. Just $10.95 a week for 19-inch color TVs. Only $12.95 weekly for stereo systems. Just $15.95 a week for video recorders, even microwave ovens. In fact, Air and Rent's money-saving weekly rates are far less than those you may have encountered elsewhere in the galaxy. Call now, because now Air and Rent's also rents electronics, too.
We love catfish from Church. It's delicious. It's southern fried catfish. Farm-raised and grain-fed from Church's fried chicken. We love it. It's catfish delicious at Church's. Church's dipped in seasoned corn meal, then fried gold. So taste fresh, not fishy. It's catfish at Church's. We love catfish from Church's fried chicken.
New Southern Fried Catfish. It's farm-raised and grain-fed.
Catfish from Church's.
Soybean growers, chances are Lexone DF pre-emergence weed killer controls your toughest weed problems. Like pigweed, beggar weed, sickle pod, tea weed, hemp sesbania. Lexone DF. Your first line of defense against broadleaf weeds, only from DuPont.
I want Monday night to be here now. I don't want to wait. What,
big action coming up here, huh?
I'm telling
regular
you.
Regular prices?
10 matches, regular prices, and some of the names that are coming back. I just love it. What a night of action it's going to be. You can get your tickets today. Why wait? Go by the Coliseum or any of the Ticketmaster locations, if that makes sense for you, in their location, like in Millington, where it's a long drive into the Coliseum. Whip on by and get your tickets today, friend, because the regular prices are in effect, and it is going to be a super night. Mark Batten will be going against Speedy Talltree in the opening. Brad Batten going against Big Iron Mike Sharpe. Nick Patrick and David Haskins will be in a tag match against Randy Rose and the Golden Boy, Chick Donovan. Mr. Wrestling and Mr. X against Ted and Jerry Oates coming in for this tag match. Doug Summers and Jerry Bryan will have their hands full as the red-hot Steve Constant and Tim Ashley will be ready for another victory, they hope. Jerry Oski, here's a guy that's on a run, will be trying to prove a point to brother Lanny Poffo. That'll be one kind of face down right there with Oski and Poffo. Following that, the universal heartthrob Austin Idol going against the international playboy Bobby Colt. And immediately on top of that one, Wildfire Tommy Rich will be in the Coliseum against the Moondog, and you'll be looking forward to some action there. How do you think Stan and Steve are going to go with the fabulous ones facing the PYT, Austin, and Ware? You better believe with the AWA titles up, going to be a fight. I mean, absolutely World War III breaking out all over the Coliseum. And then, the man is back. Jerry the King Lawler, who underwent the punishment from Savage. I can tell you it was something when Jerry had to lay off. They told him medically, you better get that neck in shape, and Jerry finally says, I can't stand it anymore. I gotta have him. The Macho Man, Randy Savage and the King. He could not even wait. After the Bockwinkel bout last Monday night, Lawler had to come out there, and you can see it caught the cameraman by surprise. Lawler comes flying across there and slams Savage. He is not only ready, he is intense, my friend. And I've heard Savage use that word before. That crazy fool is going to be in for a battle like he has never seen when a king comes back. Make no bones about it, brother. It's going to happen. I'm going to be there. You bring the family and be there, too. Dave, I believe I have talked us flat out of time. That's okay. We had a great show. See you next week for Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.